Hop in, babe, we're going.
Woohoo!
Well, your new friends from the Netherlands used to have a house left into the mud, but an old RV called Penelope, she's a 1983. Pictures and patterns of design. Penelope loves Rob until the end of time. Well, RVlicious, if you like a vibe, please subscribe. Please subscribe.
Hello, buddies.
Hello.
Ah, it's July, and it's raining. Welcome to the Netherlands.
Yes.
Going to show you how to build a bed for less than $50 using no tools,
none whatsoever,
no skills, no mechanical knowledge.
No.
We're only using one tool.
The brain.
Yes. We always lived in rental houses. So we never learned how to do it yourself.
No, you're not allowed to do anything.
You can't even put on a painting in the wall. You can't even put a nail in the wall.
No.
Or the rental commission will be suing you for damages to their property. So yes, we never learned how to do it. We also don't have room to haul toolboxes with us.
Yeah.
Don't have the skills to handle tools. No. We don't need to bring tools.
Easy.
Easy peasy. We think many people nowadays don't know how to do it yourself in DIY. Do it yourself.
Just hire someone.
Yeah, you hire someone to do it for you. And something we tried to. Somebody helped us do something, but what's the bigger disadvantage of that?
That we could not change it if it was not to our liking.
For a long time we haven't been satisfied or happy with how our van and the inside was functioning for us. We live in this van full time. It's a Mercedes 207D camper van from 1983.
Yep.
It's not very big. We have a little space.
Yes.
It's in the width, we have 1.70 meters to work with. And in the length, from the doors to the driving chairs, it's 2.80 meters to work with. So, what do we need from our camper van on the inside? We need two things.
An office, workspace, and a bed, of course, to sleep in.
Sleep in.
It's simple.
Our workspace is very important. We both have a laptop, and we both want to work on it whenever we want to work on it. And because I'm a writer, I often want to work at night when it's quiet, and Peter can go to sleep, and I want to keep working. Before, we never could do that.
No.
And that bothered us sometimes. If I was working and Peter was sleepy, he would get cranky.
Yeah.
And if I had to come to bed with Petra, which is not always a punishment, of course, but if you want to keep working, and I had to stop working because we had to build up the bed, then I got cranky. So no matter which way we turned it, one of us would be cranky.
Indeed.
And in a small van, you don't want to be cranky with each other, right?
No. Not really.
You don't want that.
No.
I love you so much.
Ditto.
Ditto. Wow, amazing.
Ditto.
So, only thing that we brought is a measuring tape.
Yes.
And like we said, we have 2.80 meters to work with.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if we sit with the laptops, mm-hmm. both laptops are 40 centimeters in width.
Yeah.
And the table is 2.40 meters, 2.80, and the table is exactly that. Yeah, so, but it's not the laptops that we have to measure. Yeah. It's our chairs. So we both have a chair.
Yes.
And if we want to sit like this, which we often do when we eat or when we watch a movie or when we want to vlog, the chairs have to fit next to each other, which is 1 meter and 20 centimeters, both of them, like 60. Oh. Yeah, 60 for my chair, and 60, a bit less for Petra's chair.
Mm-hmm.
So, 120 from the 280,
mm-hmm.
if you take that away, it's 160 spare,
yes.
is left. So, we made a bed in the length, and it's 1 meter 60 long.
Yeah.
Now, I'm 180, and Petra is about 170, meaning that our feet stick
out. But it doesn't matter. When we were in the width of the van, you could not stick out your feet, you could not stretch. You had to curl yourself up in order to get some sleep. Because we couldn't stretch, we got our lot of complaints in the knees and hips, and of course not enough sleep. Because of the irritating sleeping position.
So we looked for a solution where we didn't need any tools,
mm-hmm.
didn't need any skills,
nope.
didn't need a lot of money to make
a budget bed.
Under the bed is now no storage anymore. That's another big part of it.
Yep.
No storage under the bed.
Mm-hmm.
Meaning everything in the van is accessible by us at any time.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you have storage under the bed, you put something in there, you forget about it, you don't touch it in a year, you're still hauling it around.
No, not really.
When we were building this new bed, this budget bed,
mm-hmm.
we found a lot of stuff that we never used, we got rid of that.
Yep.
And minimalized. Minimalizing is key in this.
Yeah.
So this is what we did. It's 160. We dangle our feet to stretch.
Stretch.
And we can get out easily. Because mm-hmm. it's 160,
yep.
It's Petra's lying on 1/2, I'm lying on 1/2. We can mm-hmm. individually get out without waking each other up.
Yep.
And that meaning Petra can go to bed mm-hmm. and I can keep working. No more crankiness. Or
mm-hmm.
if I want to do an afternoon nap, I can do it too. Because we now have a bed that we are is clear of clutter.
Yep.
We can go to bed like right now, Petra.
Awesome.
Right now we could do it.
Yes.
Ah, this is bliss. So we're now on the bed with our feet dangling out.
Yes.
It's awesome. Cool. That's how we do it.
Yes.
It's very, very easy.
Mm-hmm.
And now you guys are curious, how did we do this?
Yes.
Basically, this is the bed.
Yes. Two pallets.
Two pallets.
One, two.
And this pallet is 120 in width and it's 80 in length. So 80 plus 80 is mm-hmm. 160.
Yes.
So this is the space where Petra is standing. It's a space between Petra and the table. And we just put the stuff on the toppings over here.
Mm-hmm.
This is where the feet are dangling.
Yes.
This area. It's 40 centimeters.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a lot. And because I folded up this chair, see, this is all the extra space that we have. So 40 centimeters here, but in reality more.
Yes.
So if we need to go to the toilet in the night, this is basically where we do that.
Yes.
In this area, mm-hmm. I mean.
Easy peasy.
Yeah, it's easy peasy.
Mm.
Hello, Petra.
Hello.
So, What do we have under these pillows?
The wheel arches.
It's the wheel arch.
Yep.
As you can see, buddies, it's a huge wheel arch.
It's huge. And it's a tight fit.
It's a huge wheel arch. Mm. So it means that this pallet, 120, it couldn't be wider because there's a huge wheel arch in the way.
Yep.
And same for this side, which you covered up with some old pillows.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
But because the wheel arches don't go all the way in the length, we have storage over there. There's a little toolbox. Here's a little heater. Here, it's like snow equipment, a little butane heater. We got rid of the other one to save space.
Yes.
We never had money for petroleum anyway.
Mm-hmm.
So these are two pellets, mm-hmm. and they're loose from each other. See, you can just pull them aside.
Mm-hmm. Indeed.
And now you guys must wonder what is under there.
Yes.
What a genius.
Mm.
What kind of genius is under those
solution did we
pallets?
Think of.
So, and the pallets were $12.50 per piece.
Mm.
So that's $25.
Yeah.
It's sturdy, it is easy to clean, it's lightweight.
Yes.
And it can take over 1,000 kilograms.
Mm.
So you can do some heavy duty stuff on that bed. With my weight, it's important.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to worry about cracking through the bed.
No. That's way more expensive than two pallets of $12.50.
Yeah, so $25 for the pallets is basically the base of the bed.
Yeah.
But what do we use to heighten up the bed a little bit?
Yes, we're going to show you. Mm, it was Patrick's idea to maybe use beer crates.
Yes.
But yeah, that was getting a little bit too expensive for our budget. So then we kept thinking and brainstorming and thinking. And we came up with these bad boys.
It is stepping stool. How much does one cost?
It was about €3, I think.
Yeah.
€3 per stepping stool.
And we bought how many stepping stools?
We bought eight of them.
Eight. So yep. That's our secret. Eight stepping stools.
Yes.
8 times €3 is 24.
Yep.
Adding it with the price of the pallets of 25, it's €49 for a bed.
Mm-hmm.
So how?
You might want to add the anti-slip mats we also bought, so our bed wouldn't move while driving.
Yeah, we bought anti-slip mats.
So
they were €1 per anti-slip mat.
Yeah, so that makes it 52, to be precise.
We have three mats?
Three mats, yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, three mats for €1 per piece. So it doesn't slide, but it also doesn't slide because it's wedged in.
Yeah, also, so this simple little stepping stool.
It's a little camping stepping stool.
Yep.
It's one that we also put outside of the camper van.
It can also take a lot of weight, 150 kilos, yeah. I believe.
Yes.
So.
One stepping stool. This is what we use outside of the
van.
Outside of the van.
Yes. It's about 22 centimeters.
22 centimeters. And the height of a pallet.
The pallet is 16 centimeters.
38.
Let me get on here. You see, very sturdy.
Yeah.
Each stepping stool can hold about 150 kilos, so it's sturdy. Yes.
It's super sturdy.
Super sturdy. Let me show you guys.
And this is old Petra's strength. This is old Petra. Hey, have we found your sandals?
Oh, there they are.
Yes.
Wow. So we do have a little bit of storage, but not much.
So now.
And a blooper.
Sort of a blooper.
Sort of, yes. Oops. Tree.
Per pallet, we got 4 stepping stools, easily stacked. Yep. So it's like a space saver. Mm. Here we have. Oh yeah. You want to describe what you see here?
3 anti-slip mats.
Anti-slide mats. Anti-slip, anti-slipping mats. Mm-hmm. Which we put on the floor.
Yes. We still have to buy some vinyl, but that's for later.
Yeah, this pallet has a ski here, and a ski there, and a ski over here.
Mm-hmm.
So, what we basically do... Paper?
Yes. We just wedge them in between here. As far as you can go. That's is it. No glue, no hammers, no nails, no screws, no screwdrivers, no drills. Just wedge it in between the keys.
Yeah, it's already wedged in, as you can see. The stepping stool is wedged in.
Easy peasy.
In the pallet, so this is the stepping stool. So it's pretty airy.
Yeah, very airy. We like it.
So you can just, of course, put the pallet on its back and then press really tightly.
Yeah,
so
you can even push it farther.
And push it in as far as it goes.
Yep.
And then we can measure it.
Mm-hmm.
You can measure the actual height. It's about 27 centimeters, so a bit less than less than 30 centimeters. But for us, I mean, we are not the most acrobatic people, but it's plenty.
Yeah,
it's plenty.
It's high enough.
It's high. Yeah, it's high enough.
Mm-hmm.
And you can of course use this as a base and then put stuff, put an extra thick mattress on top of the pallets. Yeah. You can stack up on the pallets, you can put stuff on there to heighten it.
Yep.
If you want a higher pallet, but this is basically the basics,
yeah.
You just wedge them in.
Yes.
Let me show you another one.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. So, take another stepping stool.
Mm-hmm.
I'll just...
Another stepping stool.
The meatball minis.
Mm-hmm.
There's a nice opening, so
yeah,
put my hands in here.
Everything again. Yep.
I'll just wedge it to the skis.
Mm-hmm.
And there it is already.
Mm-hmm.
It's wedged in.
Awesome.
It's super easy.
Super easy and super awesome.
So here it is.
Yeah.
Wedged in. And it's super spacey. Some stuff fits under here.
Yeah, like sandals.
Well, now we just have to finish... Finish the bed, put in the other 2 stepping stools.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And it's really that simple.
Mm-hmm.
And we tried it, driving with it and anti-sliding.
Yep.
So it's just, I mean, $50.
Yeah.
And it only cost us 25 of 24 for the stepping stools.
Mm-hmm.
Because we already had
the pallets. Yeah, I don't think you can ever get a bed that cheap anywhere.
And it's so super sturdy also.
Mm-hmm.
So.
You're all wedged in.
Let me wedge it out here for a second.
Yes.
I'm just turning it.
Mm-hmm.
So. You can, could secure it with rope or cord.
Yeah.
You can secure it better.
You could, but it is not necessary.
So far it has not been necessary.
Yeah. Mm.
So,
So.
Put it down. Let's see. Wow. Easy peasy.
So.
Wow.
So, this is a foam layer. This is not included in the price because we don't really need those. You can put a mattress on there or a yoga mat.
Or whatever you want.
Whatever, just whatever is available to you.
Yes.
We don't want to use mattresses because of the fungus.
Yes.
So we use
a
thin foam layer.
Mm-hmm.
And we use, of course, our air beds. Here you go, this is mine.
We put it with the points outside, so these won't slide.
Yes.
Otherwise.
They slide.
They slide. There's one.
There's one air bed.
One air bed. And this is the second air bed.
We're not using a mattress. It doesn't get wet. This airbed can get wet and it dries easily.
Yeah. And of course, if one breaks, you can replace it.
Yeah, and a mattress is heavy. And attracts dust and everything.
This is our bedspread.
The bedspread.
Like so.
Basically, that's our bed, buddies.
Yep.
So see, buddies, even if you are of an exceptional weight or on a low budget,
tight budget,
and you have a cargo van that is empty, or if it's not, you can take out. The kitchen had to, we sacrificed our kitchen.
Yes.
But we don't eat meat.
No.
So we don't need a fridge to keep the meat cold. When we go to the store, we buy everything. If it needs to be cold, we buy it when we need it.
Yep.
If we want to eat it that day.
Exactly.
We don't need a big kitchen.
Mm-hmm.
That's the beauty of it.
No, exactly.
And
we do not. Mm-hmm.
So, in your case, if you're wondering where we put all our storage.
Up there.
It's up there. So the cabin is free to drive, and here's storage. And when we drive, this is our cooker, which you can put on the table.
Mm-hmm.
And this is our supplies, one supply bag. And behind those are clothing bags and toiletries.
Mm-hmm.
It's that simple.
Yeah.
When we sleep, we'll just
close these.
Mm-hmm. Close the curtains. We sleep like this. And then we have the privacy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And that's how we do it. So that's how you build a bed. With no skills, no tools. Just using your brain.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well.
We're gonna have a nap.
And hard work vlogging.
Hard work, yeah. We're tired now. We're gonna have a little power nap. Yeah, leave us a comment if you liked it.
Mm-hmm.
And check out our new website, which we put in the video.
And in the description.
Yeah.
Below.
And if you like it and you want to support us, check out our website too for that.
Mm-hmm.
Or the links in the description.
So you can see what we can do with our skills.
Yeah. And see you in the next one, buddies.
Mm-hmm. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.